not everyone that gets up here and tells their story. So thank you for joining us. We're going to keep going here. We are calling Megan up to the mic next. Clap until Megan gets up here. Keep clapping, keep clapping, keep clapping.
Thanks, it's been a while. Okay, I'm just gonna go straight into it because I am very nervous all the time. Ladies are the type of women that make you feel inferior when you forget to drape the pearls passed down to you by your mother through her mother and her mother around your neck to signify that there is a legacy of history embedded within those well-strung beads of birth-giving, homemaking, housewifing oppression. Or if on Sunday you misplace the oversized and heavy hat that burdens you with expectations not from a Lord above, but the ever-present swell of a humanly chorus of a God-fearing congregation as if their propriety exists within the context of the things they own and not the actions they exhibit. Ladies are the type of women that move in packs. Afraid to stand on their own, nervous in the face of independence, they glide about on their hypocrisy, the same way that their words slide across your skin, graceful and unassuming, but slicing and piercing as they call you slut, whore, bitch, as if their words are a part of the very built of their souls, lily white and pure, innocent in nature, but vipers always lay in wait in the grass of Victorian ideals. And I've often wondered, if a lady is the epitome of the beauty of women in our society, then what does that say about women as a whole? Are we doomed to be virginal and proper? Are pristine gloves unadorned with the dust of lustful thoughts and impure desires that come naturally to our mirrors of men? Are we not allowed to find ourselves in sexuality, exploring the ends of our minds in pursuit of answers to a womanhood that was given to us by a holy birth of hope and loneliness? Women live in a realm that is made by the society which surrounds them. And while we must not be loose, we must not be prudes, but when ladies look at women, all women, and pass a judgment to form a criteria for how we need to be touched, heard, and loved, are they not falling into a cycle built by men that defines who we are without ever listening to our voices, discovering our secrets, or knowing what we are down to our cores? You see, all ladies are women, but not all women are ladies.